The Cricket World Cup, just about a week away. How good has Sri Lanka's preparation been? Has it been chaotic or has it been good? Let's find out. Hello and welcome. Let's talk cricket. They say practice makes perfect. Now, have the Sri Lankans practiced enough? Let's look at the Sri Lankan preparation from about January. Well, to start with, how confident is the team? Played away and then played a provincial tournament, and that's how the team was selected. And then what happened? There was going to be a camp, it didn't happen, and then Sri Lanka flies to England. It just gets, they try to get acclimatized, and then they play two games against Scotland, two practice matches. Is that enough? Let's try and compare it with some of the other teams. England and Pakistan played a one-day series. West Indies, Ireland and Bangladesh played a triangular series. Australia, before they came to England, they played a one-day series against a very tough opponent, India. So in that context, I think the Sri Lankan preparation has been poor. Sri Lanka needed to have more match practice. Now, let's not forget that there is a huge difference between practicing in a net and playing in the middle. Now, the issue is Sri Lanka has put in a lot of hours in the nets, but have they put in enough hours in the middle? That is my question. Kicking off the World Cup preparation, Sri Lanka was down to play two one-day internationals against Scotland. Now, unfortunately, the first game got washed off. Now, the second game, well, hats off to the Sri Lankans. It's a win. They won an international game, and that's very important. And that will help the team's morale, that will boost the confidence. And let's also not forget that Scotland is not an easy frontier to conquer. They had won their last five games. So in that context, Sri Lanka did well. But against South Africa, it was a practice game. But again, I believe winning is important. You got to play, you got to play your batsmen in, you got to play your bowlers in, but you got to also win. Because to me, winning is a habit. You know, it rubs off, just like losing. Sometimes you just keep losing and you don't know how to win. And winning in that context is so important. Time to look at some positives. Look at the Scotland game, good opening partnership. I like what I saw in Dimuth Karunaratne. Looked very solid, Avishka Fernando looked good, and the partnership was good. It was a solid base that Sri Lanka wanted. Yes, critics might say that catchers would drop. That's part and parcel of the game. You can't expect every catch to get stuck, and you don't expect to catch everything. Those are great levelers. But if you look at the team, Kusal Mendes coming in at three was good, a good opening partnership. But what worried me was Tisara Pereira being promoted in the order and Thirimana batting at six against Scotland. Now, Thirimana to me is not a finisher. You either bat him in the top three or you don't bat him at six or seven. Tisara Pereira is the man to bat at six or seven, even Isuru Udana. So in that context, I believe Lahiru Thirimana did get runs, 44 of 40 balls. Very useful, made sure that he batted till the end, but I believe he's got to be in the top three. And Tisara should be six or seven. Overall, it was a good win against Scotland, but again, I believe one of Sri Lanka's weak links is going to be the bowling. The Sri Lankan bowling did struggle, and against really tough opposition on flat pitches, I'm wondering what might happen, particularly when you're up against teams like Australia and England and even India. Yes, Lasith Malinga will be back, but how effective will he be? Because he has to bowl at the top, he has to bowl at the death. And who will be partnering him at the death? Those are the key questions. Because let's not forget, if you look at Sri Lanka's performance in the white ball format, they have two issues. One is the first 10 overs and the last 10 overs, particularly with the ball in hand. Now, the last 10 overs has been poor. And even when Sri Lanka bats, the last 10 overs has been very poor, under 7 runs an over. And with the last 10 overs bowling, Sri Lanka has conceded something like 8 runs an over. So that's an issue they'll have to look at. Now take the South African game. Yes, Sri Lanka lost it. That's fine. But I like again seeing Dimuth Karunaratne getting into runs. Very important that the stability factor comes into play. Kusal Pereira didn't get runs. Thirimana, two good shots and got out. But Angelo Matthews coming back into form, that's a positive. But Dhananjay De Silva and Tisara Pereira worry me as batsmen. So Sri Lanka will have to work around it. Now today, even as I speak, the next practice game will happen. So I'm hoping that Dhananjay De Silva will have a chance. Then Kusal Pereira will have a chance to get amongst the runs. Tisara Pereira. And also I've heard that Avishkar Fernando will be back because he had a little niggle. I'm hoping that he will be fine. So the Sri Lankans have a few areas to work on. But my biggest concern is going to be the bowling attack. You need good bowlers if you are to win this World Cup. Because pitches, they say, are going to be flat. Grounds are small. So runs wouldn't be too difficult. You're not looking at big hits. You're not looking at people who have to clear the boundary. You're looking at proper batsmen who score runs. But also, the big hitters will come in handy. But to me, the bowlers. A side that has wicket-taking bowlers. The side that can constantly take wickets. On small grounds, good pitches. That's the team that's going to win. Now, is Sri Lanka having that luxury? That's a question I like to ask. Well, that's where Sri Lanka is. And this World Cup in particular is a very interesting World Cup. I'll tell you why. Because 9 games, and it's about consistency. You know, only good teams can consistently win. Well, you get the odd team that can win you a game or two, but they can't maintain the momentum. Now, that's where good teams really cash in. They can lose one game, but they can win the rest. So in that context, where is Sri Lanka? Now, can Sri Lanka make it? Can Sri Lanka show that consistency? Well, many have asked me what I think the 4 finalists would be. Now, as a Sri Lankan, I would love to see Sri Lanka there. But the question is, can they do it? They certainly have it in them. If they want to do it, it's about their will. I'm hoping that they'll gel together and play well, because they certainly have potential. But in case Sri Lanka doesn't make it, I spoke about good teams being consistent. I think, to me, England, playing at home, should be hot favourites. India aren't far behind. I'm now tempted to kind of add Australia into the top 3. I would say they are the favourites. The 4th team, well, that's an interesting one. New Zealand, West Indies, Pakistan can be as unpredictable as one could imagine. South Africa, I'm not sure. So I would go with England, India, Australia for sure, and maybe New Zealand. These are my 4, but as a Sri Lankan, I'm hoping that Sri Lanka will be one of them. I don't know which team will miss out, but I'm hoping 3 plus Sri Lanka. In conclusion, my eyes fell on a very interesting situation. Mahela Jayawardena. Well, I read an interesting interview he had done, and in the midst of it, he'd made some comments about Angelo Matthews. Now, that's caught the cricket world by storm. He says Matthews should have been captain, but he fell, and he was a victim of politics. You know what I like? Angelo Matthews' response. Excellent response. He says, forget about all that. Mahela Jayawardena, come and help us to win the World Cup. Well, spoken like a true leader. I honestly feel, Angelo, you should have been captain. Yes, that's true. But then let's not talk about it. Great response. And Mahela's comments may be justified. I don't know. You got to ask him. But I like Angelo Matthews and what he said. On that note, it's time for me to say goodbye. Let's catch up the next time. This is Roshan Abeysinghe signing off from Let's Talk Cricket. Let me remind you, if you have comments or suggestions, comment below. And don't forget to subscribe, like, and share.